Welcome back to the channel, guys. In this video, we're going to take a look at re-imaging your Steam Deck. Whether you've tinkered with it too much or you're having problems with performance or whatever, if a factory reset's not enough and you want to re-image and have it just like it was when you first got it, you can certainly do that pretty easily. So let's get into it and get started. We're going to jump over onto the Steam Deck recovery website here, and I'll have a link in the description for you as well. You're able to do this on Windows, macOS, or Linux. There's instructions for you right here on the site. In this video, we're going to be concentrated on doing this on Windows with Rufus. Now you can re-image your Steam Deck, you can clear your local user data, you can reinstall just SteamOS over top of your partitions, and then you have recovery tools. Now we're going to focus on the re-imaging of the Steam Deck in this video, as it's the method to really truly take everything back to the way it was when you first got it, clears out the partitions, the SSD, and just rewrites the image onto the Steam Deck. So I'll have that in there for you. You'll also need Rufus to write this onto your USB stick. So you'll want to download that and have it ready as well. So you'll need Rufus, you'll need to download the Steam recovery, and you'll need your USB stick ready to go with either your Windows PC or whatever you're using here. So we're going to go over and click on the download from Steam's website. We're going to agree here. We're going to go ahead and click down load here, and we'll get our image for SteamOS. Once that's done being downloaded, go open up Rufus wherever you downloaded that to, maybe in your downloads folder. I moved mine over into my Steam Deck folder here. So I'll open up Rufus, and then make sure your USB is showing up here that you have plugged in. Don't accidentally do something to one of your other drives that you don't want to. Then click select. Then we're going to go and double click or open the Steam recovery image we just downloaded. And you don't need to change any other settings in here. That's all you need to do. And then we're going to click start. And it's going to warn you that it's going to wipe the drive. Again, make sure you're wiping the right drive, your USB stick. And then it's going to start writing the image. This process can take quite a few minutes. I think this one took me about 15, 18 minutes for it to write on here. It depends on your computer and the speed of your USB stick and that type of thing. But once that's done, generally it's going to do a pop-up, and it'll show you that Steam has finished writing onto the USB and you can close it. So here's mine right here, just finishing up. Everything should be good to go. So I'll be able to close out this folder. We'll click close on Rufus as well. We're done with that. And then just because I like to do it, if it'll let me, I'll eject my USB stick here. Now we're ready. We're done with the PC. We're going to jump over onto the Steam Deck and do the recovery. So here we are on the Steam Deck all set up. I've got my dock. I'm plugged in, and my USB stick is plugged into the dock. So we're going to hold the volume down button, and then we're going to press power while continuing to hold that volume down button. And I like to hold that down until the menu for boot comes all the way up. So as soon as I see that, there we go. And you can see my EFI USB device down here, the scan disk. So I'm going to go ahead and go down to the bottom here. I'm going to hit A, and that's going to boot us from the USB recovery image that we just made for Steam. Now this process sometimes takes a few minutes, sometimes not, but once it's done, it'll get into the desktop here. And again, you can see all the same options here that you saw on the website for re-imaging, reinstalling SteamOS only over top the partitions, or removing your data. But we're going to go all the way here and do the re-imaging of the Steam Deck. So we're going to use the right trigger to double tap that. It's going to warn you to make sure that you want to do this. It's going to get rid of everything on your Steam Deck and make it start completely over, like from the factory. So I'll click proceed there. And this process takes a few minutes to go through. It isn't too bad, but once it's done, it's going to go ahead and let you know that you're ready to restart. So a pop-up will come here and say proceed. You need to restart the deck to finish. So I'm going to go ahead and use my right trigger. We'll go over here and we'll click proceed, and the Steam Deck will restart for us. So we're done with the USB stick. Everything's now on the Steam Deck. And once it restarts, you'll be ready to start your setup. This is what it would have looked like when you first got it. So we're going to go ahead and pick our time zone. We're going to get logged into our internet so that we can get logged into our account. Now, before we can log into our account, it is going to do an installing process here when you re-image. So this will take 2-3 minutes, a couple minutes for it to go through. It's really not too bad. Once it gets through here, it's going to go into downloading an update. Now, once it goes into the downloading and update, I have had it just hang here. It should technically download then restart the deck to install, and it doesn't always do the restart. I've even let it sit for a couple hours before and just had it not go. So I just had to manually restart it, and then it finished. So you hit the Steam button, go to power and restart. Just make sure, you know, give it some time to do what it needs to. And if it doesn't restart on its own or finish, you can go ahead and do a restart, and then you'll be okay to go from there. So now that I have restarted, and it did do it on its own this time, it's finishing installing the update, everything for the first time here, and launching into Steam. All right. Now we're launching the Steam. Now what it will do after the update is ask you for your language and your time zone and everything again, but it remembers what you picked before. So it's really quick and you don't have to go through that install process. So you get logged in. Once you get logged in, again, this is just like when you got it from the factory. So you did all these steps when you first got your Steam Deck. I'm just showing them again here. And now we're in and it looks just like it did when we first turned it on when we first got it. So it's a pretty simple process all in all. Getting your image from the website, getting Rufus, writing that image to your USB, plugging it into the Steam Deck, booting to the USB, re-imaging the deck, and then rebooting the deck and going through your setup process. It isn't too bad, but takes a little bit of time, but it's nice. If you have any problems with your Steam Deck that a factory reset isn't handling, doing this should be able to help you out. But anyways, guys, I hope this helped you for re-imaging your Steam Deck. Thanks a lot for coming to watch. As always, if you haven't already, subscribe, thumbs up, or ring the bell. Leave me your comments below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.